James Gichuru Rironi Road project is a 26-kilometer road project. Currently, it is a dual carriageway, two-lane either side, but it is being expanded, meaning we are talking of a total of 10 lanes, the whole kilometer stretch. And for such works to be done, including the bridges which have to be done at the interchanges and the likes, we are talking of employment opportunities in the region of not hundreds but thousands. So directly we have thousands of our men and women engaged in both highly technical jobs and small jobs. Indirectly, we have a number of businesses around the area who are directly supplying to the project. James Gichuru, it's a very important junction for us because that's James Gichuru Junction. It's a point where the road from Westlands meets the point where the project starts. At the same time, we have the junction to Red Hill, Gigiri. Then we have the famous James Gichuru Road, which connects Wayaki Way and Ngong Road. This particular junction has a very high traffic. Because of that, the stretch between James Gichuru and Rironi has been overstretched in terms of traffic volume.
Wayaki Way shida yenye tuko nayo sana ni jam. Hoping sasa barabara ikiisha.
The road itself currently as it is, the traffic numbers going through there have really increased, so it requires intervention in terms of improving its capacity. In addition to that, the condition of the existing road is not good enough. The riding quality of the road is not good enough. It requires some improvement so that we can at least ensure that even those who are driving on it are comfortable enough. So we are improving the pavement itself in terms of ensuring that the riding quality is good. Then in addition, we are also trying to ensure that we take care of the traffic numbers. Motorists are currently taking a very long period of time between James Gichuru to Rironi. We want to save travel times for motorists who are operating that stretch of the road. This road is part of the Northern Corridor. The Northern Corridor is our main highway from Mombasa going to Western Kenya through Malaba. So this road carries the highest volume of traffic loads in the country. And in engineering terms, we are actually talking about designs to T0. T0 means it's the highest standard of pavement which you can do on our roads. So we are doing it the highest standard we expect to be done in our roads. The section between Gitaru and Rironi, that is now the junction where the Southern Bypass meets the main highway, all the way to Rironi, on your way to Nakuru, we are going to do it concrete pavement standard. It's a stretch of about 10-12 kilometers. The reason why we are doing it concrete pavement standard is the traffic loading we are expecting on that road as a result of its expansion. And if we expect it to survive for 20 years minimum going forward, for that road to survive for all that time, to take care of those trucks which are carrying heavy loads along that stretch, we need to do it concrete standard. Meaning we could not do it the normal bitumen standard which we do on most of our roads. We've had some tremendous delay in completing the project within that time. The reason why we have had such a delay is because we have had challenges in acquiring land from private developers who are abutting the road. The project road as it is two lanes on either side, so we are talking about four lanes. But we are expanding it to 10 lanes. To do that, you need to acquire land. So that land acquisition is a lengthy process. It has taken us a while, but as a government, we have so far substantially paid for land acquisition. We've done a number of feeder routes, feeding the main road in the rural areas of Kiambu County. And these roads are opening up rural Kiambu. We thought that in as much as we are talking about international regional trade being facilitated through this project, we thought of also improving the domestic trade. So the domestic trade has been enhanced by ensuring that we have done a number of collector routes or feeder routes under this project. In addition to that, we have a plan in place of ensuring that we improve the market centers along where the project is traversing. And this is about ensuring that the project, other than just serving as a main transport corridor, it was also serving the local traders who are abutting the main road. This stretch of the road between James Gichuru and Rironi has many other roads and feeder roads which are joining the main road. So we are doing a modern interchanges along the road so that we can have better connectivity with the estates around. So the estates along the corridor are not being left in isolation. We are having them connect to the main road. So it's a very comprehensive project, and at the end of it all, we expect that things will be well. The value of properties along that corridor has improved tremendously. That goes directly into improving the economy of that area. Other than improving regional trade between Kenya and our neighboring countries, it's also improved greatly the economy of the counties of Nairobi and Kiambu.
When this road is completed, we are going to have more clients. Already our customers are asking me, when is the road going to be completed? And they are waiting for the road to be completed, because from Nairobi, somebody will be driving here with 17 minutes. It is 17 kilometers from Nairobi. So most customers from Nairobi, they will be coming here, and we shall be able to cater for them. And we shall have more clients, and the business will be good.
The pedestrians, we are having walkways which are being constructed all the way along the project. So pedestrians will also enjoy. So even bicycle riders will enjoy using the road once it's done.